Today I've got a DOM RS8. It's an 8-pin core in total. We have a main row of pins, which has 5 pins, and we have 5 side pins, which are not sliders. They're really pins with key pins and driver pins. Only difference is for picking, we can't access the side pins from the top. We have to scratch on them and try to slide them down like this. Yeah, so the key also works. It's a rather easy bitting. yes, so it makes a difference if we turn attention clockwise or anti-clockwise. For anti-clockwise, the main 5 pins bind first. For anti-clockwise, the side pins bind first. I found this for, I've picked 2 of these locks on each side, and it has been the same on all these, like this. So I think it's for all the locks like this. So I'll start with the main pins bind first. So tiny click out of 1, click out of 2, nothing on 3, nothing on 4. 5 is binding, click out of 5, back to 1, click out of 1, nothing on 2, 3, 4, or 5. So let's go to the side pins, scratch on them. No, they don't really bind already, so let's go back. 1, nothing on 1. Nothing on 2, 3, nothing on 4, maybe 5, I just can't feel it so good. Or maybe. So 1 is good. Ah, now 2, click out of 2, 3, 4, now 5 is okay. And 1 is okay. Now let's go to the side pins. Now the side pins feel better. So that's the first one, and we could see some rotation on the core. So now the spool pins on the main 5 should interact, and we can find which ones are spools. 3 and 4 obviously should be spools since they didn't bind. So I'll try to set them. 3 doesn't bind. No. So let's check 1, 2, 3, and 4. Let's set 4 first. Okay. So I think we lost the side pins, but that's how it has to be. 1, 2. Now 3 still doesn't bind, but let's see if we can get counter rotation. Yes. Let's see what we dropped. 1 is good, 2 is good, 3 is still up. So we have to pick 5. So now I could set 3 and 4. So 5 was okay. 1 is good, 2 is good. 3 is away. I can't reach it with this pick. 5 is good. So let's go back to the side pins. First, probably second. So that's it. Okay. So normally it's easier to pick it. I was just, I don't know. So let's get this to the side. So I have never disassembled it before because I'm not sure how my self-made separated followers work on this. So I'll find out now. So now we need, so here we can clearly see the picked side. I hope it's not too dark. Yeah. So it's picked and it turns freely up. Yeah, it turns and this side is not picked. So I pop the key in and pull out the core just a tiny bit so I can get this stuff out, hopefully. So this is out. Now I can use my self-made followers, which are just made from a pen, and I insert them from here. Let's see if it works. Oh no, the core is too small. So let's make it a little different. So the, as you can see, the core is smaller than I would expect. So I'll just, let me see. Maybe this. Yeah, probably I can reassemble it with this if I cut it. So let me try to just take it apart like this. So here is number 5. It's this kind of pin. And the first key pin. Let's get it out with this. Oh, so there were also wafers inside. And we have a standard key pin. So, but since, yeah, the wafers in here don't play too much of a role since they never engaged with the shear line. And here we have a torpedo-shaped key pin without wafers. So let's take the first side pin. Let's just dump it. So that's the side pin. I'll show it later a bit better. So it's the first side driver, now the next main pin. I dropped it. It's, as we saw while picking, it's a spool. So from now on it will get more difficult. So here we have something springing out. I think it was a wafer. Come on. Also, this was the first and the second key pin, that's like this. So there's, this, the next side pin, and already the third one comes shooting out. So this was number 3, also a spool from the main pins, and here should come maybe the last, we have some springs, and here we have the first side pin driver. Now let's just another barrel on number 2, and now the first one is also a barrel. So, and pin number 4. So we got two parts of drill protection. Ah no, these are the side pins. Lol. This goes there, this goes there. Yeah, the gutting is not as intended. So these are side pins number 2 and 3. And the first one is here. And key pin number 5 is here. Luckily, we have a key, so we can pin it up correctly later. So let's find out. So I think this is number 5. So let's put it in slot number 5, but the right way. Number 3, slot number 3, so the last. And it's a bit too long, or maybe this is within the tolerances. Yeah, it should be. Or it's one. So 3 and 1 were very close, so maybe it's just one. Nope, it's number 3, so it was correctly assumed. So the springs of the main pins. This smaller springs for the side pins. So we have the core here. Maybe I can use a flashlight, which is not too bright, so we can see it. Yeah, so you can see there are 3 side pins, 3 main pins in there, nothing done to the core. And here we have the 5 main pins and the 3 side pins. We also have tiny notches here because these are off center, so they have to have these angled cut on the end. So they don't stick out of the plug. Yeah, so they have to get something to stay oriented. And now here we can, yeah, maybe I'll show it closer. Okay, like this. So first the pins. So the first driver is a barrel pin and a standard key pin. Number 2 is also a barrel pin, and the key pin is very interesting. It's a torpedo. So pin number driver number 3 is a nice spool. If it's focusing, it's maybe like this. I make manual focus. So here we can see the spool, the same spool for number 3, number 4. Number 5 is a barrel again. So we got these torpedo pins. Maybe I can show it again. In number 2 and number 4, we got interesting driver pins for the side pins. They look like this. You can see the tip is angled and has this part of a circle cut out, like because, and where's the plug? Here. It slides along the plug like this. So like this. So it has to have this cut, because if it's a square thing, it's just not. So we get a bigger shear line, and that's it. And also here, we have this rounding matching as a negative to the driver pins. We get different heads, I think. Yeah. So here we have, this is the third one. We can check on the key. So as you can see, it's it makes a difference if it's if the key cut touches the outer part or the tip. So you can see on the key we have two levels on the side part. We have one closer to the main key part and one to the outside. So if we have this, we can get master keying, because like this it's higher than if there was an outer part pushing this tip. Oh, sorry. This tip can get pushed down by this one before this outer layer, or if there's no outer layer, we have an inner layer. So I think there's like two levels, depending if we have this key pins inside or these key pins. So these just ignore one layer because it's cut away from there. So they just take the outer profile. Yeah, so that's it on the DOM RSH. Thank you for watching.